Dear friends, this is Srinivasan, who is having more than 40 years experience in this construction industry, trying to present you a small presentation on building plan approvals, sanction from commencement to occupation certificate. It's a civil conclave presentation. As I come across, many of the engineers doesn't know or might not be understanding what are the procedures to be followed from the land acquisition to the handing over the building to the society, resulting them running to pillar and post. I try to explain all these things in this small presentation. Kindly watch till the end. Suggest your comments and suggestions, please. This might help you, all engineers, to understand what is meant by approval and sanction. That is, from the commencement certificate to occupation certificate. It's a civil conclave presentation. The average person fantasies about climbing a house. Long periods of reserve funds and cautious ventures are engaged with buying a house level. In this manner, make certain of the legalities while buying a level, that is a house. The house is a reasonable title land. It adjusts to the predominant standards and guidelines of the concerned structure plan, endorsement from company, government specialist, and so forth. The structure development must go through different procedures and get distinctive structures plan, endorsement from enterprises, government specialties. Purchase of land and power of attorney. The developer chooses the area of the plot and haggles with the property manager about the terms and condition for the buy and improvement of the said plot. A legitimate counselor should be delegated to get the pursuit report and explore the title freedom zone, ELC, subtitles, and so forth. In the wake of getting the green sign from the promoter, understanding the deal, satyakat, should be executed by paying a piece of the buy cost and fixing the further methods of installments. Intensity of the lawyer should be gotten from the property manager for the sake of the developer, through which he is enabled to build up the land by developing a structure of apartments. The intensity of the lawyer enables him to sign the reports and submit plans for endorsement. Some authoritative archives examined here need to be confirmed prior to buying the level. The title leeway declaration from the owner. The arrangement available to be purchased between the property manager and the developer. Plan from the town arranging authority. Zone, non-agricultural land, ELC, furthermore, demarcation. Zone, government authorities have divided the land into various zones based on their uses as given below. Residential zone, commercial zone, service industrial zone, industrial zone, hills and hill slopes zone. ULC, urban land ceiling. The object of the ULC act to fix a roof empty land in a metropolitan zone and encourage the obtaining of such abundances, place that is known for a roof limit, and to direct the development of structure on a such a land. As indicated by the Metropolitan Land Roof Act, concerned must be gotten from the creating of the land from the Metropolitan Land Roof Office. ULC limit implies retainable land to be kept by the landholder and the leftover segment is to be announced excess. The breaking point for Metropolitan Land Roof fluctuates from city to city. An authority ULC request should be acquired for surplus abundance land. ULC request implies that in the wake of choosing the roof case, the region of retainable land and excess land will be dictated by the occupied equipped position. The government can absorb excess land and permit developments of pads under specific conditions. Application for non-NA, that is a non-agricultural, can't be made without a ULC request. NA, non-agriculture. According to the prevailing rules and regulation, construction is not allowed on agricultural residential building land. Hence, application for NAU should be submitted to the concerned authority with the necessary papers and NA charges as applicable. No building construction is allowed without a grant of the NA use certificate. Demarcation. The demarcation of the land is done by the city surveyor. An application should be submitted along with the latest 7x12 extract, property register card, and a copy of the power of attorney. The date and time are given by the city surveyor office for the measurement of the plot. The notice should be given to the adjacent property owners by the city surveyor office for attending the time of measurement. The owner should be present at the time of measurement and extended all required help by supplying laborers, lime powder, flag, etc. at the time of actual measurement. The approved demarcation plan is then received with a stamp and seal at the office. Preparation of building plan from the architect. Once the preliminary formalities are completed, the architect prepares a drawing for a building construction, considering rules of FSI, that is the floor space index, or FAR, floor area ratio. FAR is equal to total covered area on all floors plot area. Architect should also consider side margins, etc. Rules observed for building construction from the architect. Plinth region of the ground floor ought to be multiple of 2 to 1/4 of the plot zone. Building edge from the plot line should be at least 4.5 meter away from the front fundamental street, 3 meter setback from back and side lines. All back and side setback edges rely upon the stature of the structure. The base region of each room should be 9.5 square meter with a base broadness of 2.4 meter. At any rate, one mass of each room should be the outer mass of the structure. The base territory of the kitchen should be 5.5 square meter with a base broadness of 1.8 meter. The base zone of a kitchen come feasting should be 9.5 square meter with a base expansiveness of 2.4 meter. The base zone of the restroom territory should be 1.8 square meter with a base expansiveness of 1.2 meter. The base region of WC should be 1.1 square inches with a base broadness of 0.9 meter. The base region of the latrine should be 2.8 square meter with a base expansiveness of 1.2 meter. The base structure of the WC, shower and the latrine should be 2.2 meter. Openings for ventilation should be 0.35 square meter with one element at least 0.3 meter. All lofts should be 2.2 meter above the floor level. The area of the windows and ventilators of each room should not be less than 1/8 of the area of that particular room. The height of the parapet wall of the terrace should be between 1.05 to 1.2 meter above the finished terrace level. The height of the compound wall should be calculated from the center of the road and 1.05 meter above it. The compound gate should always open inside One flight of the staircase should be a minimum of 1 meter wide, with a tread minimum of 0.25 meter and riser of maximum 0.18 meter. The headroom above the landing should be a minimum of 2.2 meter. Water requirement should be calculated with the assumption of 5 persons per tenement and 135 liter per day per person, and accordingly overhead water tank should be designed. Commencement certificate. At the point when the arrangement set up according to the standards, 4 duplicates of the plan should be submitted alongside in the accompanying drawing. Building design endorsement plan from the improvement arranging office must be acquired. The arrangement will show the absolute design, area of different structures, alongside the territory left as open space, garden, street, and so on. Building authorization from the structure control office must be acquired. These drawings show the level plan, level authority, apartment extent, business and private extent, entryways, window opening, section, light of stairs building, and so forth. The arrangement should be according to the DC, improvement control rules to get authorization. For endorsement, the accompanying reports are needed to be submitted alongside the plan. Duplicate of 7x2 concentrate properly enrolled card of that land. Division drawing of the land from the City Review Office, Metropolitan Land Sailing, that is the ELC office, once, if appropriate. Property tax clearance certificate. Intensity of attorney from the landowner to the manufacturer engineer. Improvement charges and security expenses to be paid as appropriate. Different archives whenever needed by the authorities. After investigation and satisfying all the necessities, the authorities demonstrate the arrangements and issues, installation and endorsement. The endorsement is substantiated for a year from the date of the issue. It very well may be re-established for one more year, up to a time of 1 year. Subsequent to getting the building authentication, plinth checking certificate. When the work up to the plinth level is complete, the concerned authority should be informed on a prescribed form to check the work up to the plinth and setbacks. The plinth checking certificate is then issued. Only after obtaining the certificate, further construction can be done. For issuing plinth checking certificate, following points are checked. Side front side margin, distance from the plot boundary, height of a plinth from the road level, measurement of the periphery of the building and other detail as per the approved plans. All these distances should tally with the approved building drawings. Drainage water road approval. The drainage work should be carried out simultaneously with the building work. All plumbing and sanitation drawing should be prepared by the consultant or by a licensed plumber. Approval from the concerned authority should be obtained before starting the work. Following are the formalities of the drainage approval. One certified copy of the approved plan. 3 copies of the plan showing all the details of material used, invert level, sizes, locations of the chambers, a newer chamber or septic tank details, connection of drain system or public drainage with a location, internal plumbing arrangement, etc. Latest commencement certificate. Tax clearance certificates. Development charges or colony line work as applicable. The plans are scrutinized and approved with changes. Complete the work according to the approved plan. Part completion. This is actually is made available by the sanctioning authority for convenience sakes. Builders can complete a part of the work and apply for the part of completion. At the time of part completion, following things should be complete. The flat shaft should be complete in all respect. access to the flat shop complete in all respect, supply of water to the flat, the drainage system from the flat to the public drainage should be completed and in working condition. NOC from the drainage water road department, NOC from various department. When the main construction work is completed, execution of other related services also require NOC from various department. So along with this NOC, we have to apply the authorities in the printed format. He get the building completion certificate. The different NOCs required to be submitted are as follows: drainage completion, road completion, water connection, encroachmental departmental, lift work from PWD if applicable, firefighting system if applicable, building completion certificate. For issuing the completion certificate, the architect should inspect the work for completion of the work as per the approved plans, type and grade of the system such as drainage system, water supply system, lift, firefighting systems. If all the conditions mentioned in the plans are complied with or not, all the fittings and fixtures should be fixed and final touch-up should be attended for all internal roads and other developments. Lift and firefighting system should be in a working condition. All the NOCs should be obtained. Architectural engineering, structural engineering should submit the completion certificate to the municipal corporation authorities, certifying the workmen's, the materials used and the completion of the works in accordance with the construction rules. Along with the report, the architect should submit 3 copies of the complete plan. He should also certify that the building is ready for occupancy and request to arrange for the occupancy certificate from the concerned authorities. Occupancy certificate. The certificate issued by the municipal corporation concerned stationing authority. After receipt of the completion certificate, the architect, the sole completer, will be inspected and verified by the municipal corporation. Tax assessment of Individual Building Act. On receipt of the occupancy certificate, municipal corporation concerned authorities, possession can be given to the final owners. The authority then access the flat tax purposes. The following information should be submitted by the builder to the tax assessment: list of member, area statement for a various flats, building electricity supplies and its formalities. The sanctioning authority for the procedure is the electricity board. The approval procedure is divided into 2 parts: getting the load obtained for the complete scheme, getting the electricity light meters for the individual lift owners, electricity light meters for individuals. Application on the prescribed form should be submitted, duly signed by the purchaser to the electricity board. These forms are normally submitted through the builder along with the allotment letter. According to the load and appliances to be used, a single phase or a 3-phase meter should be demanded. Photocopy of nearby consumer's paid light bill should be attached along with the application. After verification, electricity board issues the firm quotation in the prescribed form, which includes the amount to be paid, fixed services line charges, additional services connection charges, distribution board charges, security deposits, agreement fees, others to be specified. After paying the amount for a firm quotation, the meter is sanctioned in a due course. A safe location as specified by the electricity, the board should be allotted and the meters to be installed in the wooden board box. The meter total load sanctioned for the scheme from the electricity board. With the increased number of tenements, the total requirements of the load also increases. It should be sanctioned by the electricity board. Generally, if the building area exceeds 5,000 square meter, the load exceeds 50 kilowatts. If the extra load is not available in a particular location, then a separate transformer is required. The transformer should be installed on the premises as suggested by the electricity board. The said area has to be handed over to the electricity board on the lease basis. The formalities to be completed by the builder are as follows. Documents required for a building plan sanction of load. Application in the prescribed form. Site plan showing the proposed location of LT room and transformer plinth. Consent letter from the builder power of attorney holder for conducting LT room and transformer plinth. Copy of latest 7x12. Lease deed between electricity board and the builder. Copy of the power of attorney. Tax clearance certificate. The latest paid bill of the existing electrical meter. Approved drawing set. Full load demand letter considering. Flat wise, floor wise details of the load. Common lights, lifts, pumps, etc. The layout of interval cabling. Formalities required for building sanctioning load. After submitting all documents to the electricity board, the SLC for providing the power supply is worked out by the electricity board. The electricity board sends a letter to the builder stating SLC to be paid. After payment of SLC, all civil works of the transformer, plinth and LT room should be completed by the builder as per the electricity board requirement. The application for installing the transformer and supply of power should be complete. After verification of the LT room and transformer plinth, the transformer is installed by the electricity board. Testing reports from the electricity board inspector for satisfactory work of transformer and cabling should be issued. Charging of transformer and power supply to the project. After charging the transformer, the following procedure should be followed. Application on a prescribed form for the electrical meter. Allotment letter from the builder for the individual flat holder. FU to be received. Test report from an electrical contractor to be submitted to an electrical board for a satisfactory and safe working of the internal electric wiring. After the necessary payment as per FQ, delivery of electricity meter from the electricity board. Electricity meter fixing with the necessary fixtures for individual flat holders. Formation of the building society. On completion of the builder should hand over the building to the purchaser, either for forming an apartment or a society. The apartment can be formed for any number of members, while for form the society, a minimum of 11 members is required. An application by the chief promoter should be submitted to the register of the cooperative societies of the respective jurisdiction. Latest 7x12 extract, agreement of sale, power of attorney, list of members, bylaw book, duly signed, etc. should be submitted along with the application. The application is submitted along with the 2 or 3 suggestive names for the society. Saving account in the approval name of the society should be opened and the share amount collected from the member to be deposited in the bank. Along with the application, a general stamp paper should be submitted to the registrar of the cooperative societies. Registration should be executed on a stamp paper. Registration certificate along with the registration number is then issued to the society. After receiving the certificate, share should be allotted to the members. The chief promoter withdraws his name and the chairman, secretary and transformer and elected to the general meeting. Sale deed or conveyance deed. This is a triplicate agreement which the land and the building is transferred to the society. The 3 parties involved are the landlord as the owner, builder as the concerning party and the society buyer. According to the rules, the agreement is registered paying the appropriate stamp duty. The sale value of the all flat is the cost of the sale deed. As many legal and other formalities are involved, it is always better to appoint a legal advisor to complete the formalities. The sale deed is to be executed in the presence of sub-registrar and in presence of all the 3 parties. Thank you for watching this presentation. Kindly subscribe, like and share, which will motivate me for a further good presentation. In case of any queries, do not hesitate to write to me. The response shall be at the earliest. Contact me, civilconclave@gmail.com or at my Telegram group, Ask Srini Telegram Groups. The link is as follows. Kindly subscribe, like and share, which will motivate me for a further good presentation. Thank you for watching this presentation.